In a shocking incident, a 15-year-old girl was shot dead in Moray. Family suspects one-sided love angle behind the murder. Speaker Yumnam Khemchan appeals to people to usher better change and not to accept cash from candidates during elections. Presence of MPCC President T.N. Howkip's picture in BJP hoardings creates a stir in Congress party. And people remember Rabina and Sanjit, who were killed in a fake encounter on their 8th death anniversary. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Primetime English News and I'm Priyo Bertha with the top stories and latest news at this hour. In a shocking incident, a 15-year-old girl was allegedly shot point blank by a 21-year-old man early this morning in Moray. She has been identified as Nyenenga Khongshai, daughter of Lenkang Khongshai, presently staying at her uncle's place at Gilgan Village. The deceased girl was a student of class 9 at Mount Moray Public School. The accused is identified as Saisad Howkip, 21 years, son of Thanglet Howkip from Chawang Phai village in Moray. The incident occurred this morning around 5 at Gilgan Kul, Moray Gate No. 1. Family members rushed towards the room on hearing the gunshots and found Nyenenga lying on the sofa. They saw a man running away from the house. Family members shouted for help and the neighbors rushed out of their homes. The people informed the police who had come to pick up the girl's body that Saisad was hiding in one of the houses in the neighborhood. OC of Moray Police Station H. Chauba and J. Baite arrested Saisad from the house where he was hiding. Police also recovered a country-made 9mm pistol with 3 live rounds from the spot. Nyenenga was shot in the forehead. Family members suspected one-sided love angle behind the murder. Tension erupted when the people stormed the Moray police station when the police was taking the accused to Imphal. Police sources said Saisad is a cadre of the banned militant outfit Kuki National Army KNA. Shops in Moray downed the shutters against the killing. Meanwhile, Kuki students' organization KSO has called for a general strike till 6 p.m. tomorrow in Moray to protest the killing of the schoolgirl. Shops in Moray town remain closed today due to the general strike. Director of South Asia Human Rights Documentation Center R. Ravi Nair assured the leaders of civil society organizations in Moray that he will raise the issue of frequent crimes in Moray and inaction of the security personnel at the center to solve the problem. He was addressing the human rights consultation program organized by CSD Moray at the Convention Hall of Moray Trade Center. Executive Director of Human Rights Alert Bablu Luitongbam, Secretary of United NGO Mission Manipur Nabukishore, and other officials attended the event. Members of civil society organizations complained to representatives of human rights organizations that the lives of the people are under threat even in the presence of police and paramilitary forces. Kuki Women's Human Rights KWHR Chandal District has condemned the killing of Nyenenga Khongshai by Saisad, a cadre of Kuki National Army KNA. In a press release, the union appealed to the authority concerned to punish the culprit. Speaker of Manipur Assembly Yumnam Khemchan has appealed to the people of Manipur not to accept cash from candidates during elections to bring about a better society. Inaugurating a community hall at Nacho Maninglekai, built by Construction Committee Nacho Maninglekai today, the speaker asserted that the candidates who spend a huge amount of money during elections will try to recover the same after winning elections, neglecting developmental works for the people. He appealed to the public to usher positive change in the society. Oinam MLA L. Radhakishore also appealed to the public to elect the candidates who do not distribute money during elections and would work for the welfare of the people.
Ekor apun bagi pondol kan tak ada lebar si untuk pengamoi ngasi untuk kuah hot pada ngai ni. Mari masa itu board le kore bisa ke apa yang dah mohon. Board le bagi qualification si pasca apa yang si untuk kibla mari pergi pasca mayang wapri. Adalah pasca ke board ke mari lengah lalu si
पैसा अलग धर्म संता होगी सुनी प्रधान मेंबर जिला परिषद इलेक्शन तो कर रहे पैसा ये अंदर पी दो लाख पर आई बहुत पी दियो पैसा पी दिया ना लाख तो धर्म सं हो रहा बने तो बहुत पी नो फास्ट हिस्ट्री दा नियमित तो कोई वक्त से वो थमोश के लगे तो नियमित भी होएंगे तो
People today remember Chungkam Sanjit and Thokchom Rabina, who were killed in a fake encounter in Kwaramban Bazaar on their 8th death anniversary today, and resolved to fight together to repeal the Armed Forces Special Spars Act, AFSPA, which violates human rights from the state. Working Committee of Appunbalup and JAC against the brutal killing of TH Rabina and CH Sanjit jointly observed the 8th death anniversary at Lamyan Bashanglin Palace compound. People paid floral tributes and observed 2 minutes silence in honor of the departed souls. Speaking at the event, President of AMUCO PH Deban lamented that many people have been killed and women raped under the draconian law and none of the culprits involved has been punished. He said, even though the government of India has been saying that the world, that the CBI is probing that the crimes committed under AFSPA, no security personnel has been punished. President of CCSK Arjun Tenhaiba said, people need to be aware of the rights violation committed under the draconian act. However, he appreciated the Supreme Court's order for a CBI probe into fake encounters committed under AFSPA. President of UCM, Coordinator of Appunbalup, Pulindro Konsam, Sunil Karam, Joy Chingakam, Assistant Coordinator Joy Chandra Konthogjam, representatives of several women's organizations and student bodies attended the event.
CBI na ngasi, yamna Manipuri miyamgi da magta, ay kwegi, makwegi achumba, वफम सिंह दो कुफम न नबगी दम थवाई हचांग याउ न पन बिरंग गद भारत सरकार न मसे थवाई याउ न होनो मधु की अचुम पुथु न हैरंग गद ना की मतम लेन न नबा खरा खरा तौर गान द तौरी है बि या न नबा अशोक शाम मतम लौरी बसे कई गो अचुम ब म पुथु न नबा को नबा देलिंग टेक्टिस तौरी बा अदु अचुम बसे नमजन न नबा पनरी बा मयाम सिंह से मसि यार वे से कोई मियांग की कोलाव को लोइन ना मसि तक्षण बम थोई अदुना मसिन लोइब नते हजिक अखोई मांग मसाई की आर्मी की मियोन मिनई पुलिस कमांडो सिंह की का हेंद खवों कया अदो मसी खितंग तपथग रखचु मसी मतुंग करी तौर कदगे हाइस अपन पूछ हेंद बियाते
The presence of a picture of Manipur Pradesh Congress Committee President T.N. Haukip in hoardings of BJP Manipur Pradesh has created a storm in the Congress party. The hoardings include many BJP ministers and MLAs, including Chief Minister Nongthombam Biren. The hoarding with a picture of T.N. Haukip was displayed at the road median opposite M Sector. As soon as the news spread on social media, it was replaced by a picture of Speaker Yumnam Khemchand. Meanwhile, T.N. Haukip has accused the BJP of doing it on purpose. He said, A case will be filed at the court and cybercrime unit. Speaking to media persons at Congress Bhavan today, T.N. Haukip reminded the public that he joined the Congress in 2002 and that he will be in the party till his political career lasts. He maintained that the act carried out by BJP is a shame in the political history. T.N. Haukip said the party will also decide on future course of action regarding the matter. The Congress president maintained that the Congress will remain active although BJP tries to target the party. Haukip said he does not want to criticize the three-month-old BJP-led government. He warned of taking actions after the budget session. Meanwhile, Sharma Enterprises, who were responsible for putting up the hoardings, clarified that it was a mistake.
Meegi mathak ta gihi hejin ba adu mahoi election mamang da gi sanar ga hujik phaw ba tok ta bani. Adu Manipur ship totally confusion chanan ge hai bani. Congress president su yawra ga dore hai na. फोटो का थे चे लेगा करेनो से लेगा नो 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 अखोगी बीजेपी नंग थू न तौ अखोई हुजिक्ती वी आर कंपेल टू गो टू द कोर्ट टू सीक जस्टिस नंबर वन नंबर टू सोशल मीडिया चाहे हनबनी ना वी विल गो टू साइबर क्राइम
Mother's Care Children Hospital and Research Center and Manipur Heart Institute jointly organized a free medical camp for the children affected by flood at Tentha Khombal Multiplex today. Free drinking water was also distributed to the people. Managing Director of Mother's Care Children Hospital and Research Center, Dr. K.H. Ratan Kumar said the medical camp was organized with the support of doctors and paramedical staff of the center to help the flood affected children. Such medical camps were also held in other areas. He also said the camp not only aims at treating 200 to 300 people only, but focuses on creating awareness on prevention of waterborne diseases and benefits of breastfeeding. People of Tentha appreciated Dr. Ratan Kumar for holding the medical camp. 250 children were treated at the camp and free medicines were also distributed to them. Pediatrics Association of Manipur under the aegis of Mother's Care Children Hospital and Research Center also observed ORS Week under the theme ORS Only Rational Solution at the camp. CHC Hyrok and Block Health Society Thobal Block also jointly organized one-day reproductive and child health camp at Tentha Multiplex. MO of CHC Hyrok and many doctors treated around 200 patients at the camp and distributed medicines. Citizens Club Moirang under the aegis of Center of Medical and Sales Representatives Union CRUNER Imphal Unit organized a free medical camp for the flood affected people staying at relief camps on Moirang Sendra Road today. Five doctors provided free treatment to about 300 people. CRU also distributed free medicines at the camp. Rice seed, fodders for cattle and food items were distributed to flood victims of Moirang constituency. The items were distributed under the directives of Moirang MLA P. Sarachandra. Flood victims of Lilong Haurebi Awanglekai who were affected by the breach of Imphal River on the 2nd of this month have drawn the attention of the government to their grievances. Speaking to media spokesperson of flood relief camp Lilong Haurebi Awanglekai, Mohammed Islamuddin said, except for the few relief material collected by people from the irrigation and flood control department, nothing has been done to repair the banks. He said, people tried to block the water by repairing the river bank for 5 days. Several places, including the primary health center at Lilong Haurebi, Makalikai and Ngangau Lokol are still submerged underwater. He urged Chief Minister Nongthoman Biren to translate what he promised to the flood victims during his visit to flood-affected areas into action.
Awab sigi kan bina bagi damak aku sim ki pengi ching sendiri hoju pobda aku kudung cha basi atu ki mati wali ngangau de lei ba hospital si ising na thumjel lei re lei mi ki kudung cha phang de medical ki mai digi kem to ba aku ki huju ji pankari mi phamji da kem to ki bas lei te aduna ana abi ki kudung cha da kem mung lei hau ki basi ki mamang da hum lak chau ki ba turen da transformer se adum ising jin lupsal lupsal laga adum la kun mar moira ga transformer se hoji sin nabi yad dina aku ki कोल सा खिदना गरांग कोई फिटिंग तौर का मई स्थापो नहीं अब ट्रांसफॉर्मर से ये कहू तौर पोखाई रे सीजन नब याद रे
समाज एडवाइजर मोहम्मद रियाजुद्दीन अरिबम टुडे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड फूड आइटम्स टू फ्लड अफेक्टेड पीपल ऑफ इरोंग चेसाब हईबों मखों खेलखों उचिवा नस्ताव संथेल हंगुल एंड नखापट विलेजेस अमोकोक इरोंग टू कैरक लोकल कमिटी ऑल्सो विजिटेड द फ्लड हिट एरियाज मोहम्मद रियाजुद्दीन सेड Health camps will be held in these areas with the help of Peace Hospital Porampar to help the flood victims. He also said help will also be extended to the orphanage at Haibong Makhong. The flood affected people said the river breached banks as they are not maintained properly and many people are still taking shelter at relief camps. More than 90% of houses in Haibong Makhong were damaged by the flood and farmlands and domestic animals were also affected. They alleged that the government has not provided them any help when they are suffering due to the floods. They appealed for government's help.
ಅದು ನಸಿ ಪಾವದ ಕೋಯಿಗೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಮೈಗೆದಗೆ ಕರಿಗುಂಬಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಪಾವೈ ಕೋಯಿ ಫಂಗದನ ಲೈರಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಕೋಯಿನ ಕನೋ ತೌ ಜಬನಿ ಕನ್ ಹೈ ಜಬನಿ ತ್ರಿಪಾಲಂ ಪಂ ಅಮ್ಮ ಕಕ್ತೋ ಅರ್ಜು ಪಿಬಿ ಯೋನ ಹೈಬನಿ ಅದು ಪಾವೈ ಕೋಯಿ ನಸಿ ಪಾವ ಫಂಗದನ ಮಿಗಿ ಎನ್ಖೈನ್ ಕುಂದ ಹುಜಿ ಪೋ ಕೋಯಿ ಸೈದಾಂಗ ಲೈರಿ ಮಸಿ ಕೋಯಿಗೆ ಗವರ್ನಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೆ ಸೈತಗೆ ಕೋಯಿ ಅಥು ಮತಂದ ಮಿ ಚಂಗನಿಂಗಿ ಹುಜಿ ಹುಜಿ ಕೋಯಿನ ಕನೋ ಚೆ ದರ್ಕಾರ ಲೈರಿ ಚೆ ಕೋಯಿಗೆ ಚಾಬ ಥಕ್ಪ ಅಮದಿ ಯುಂ ಲೈಫಂ ಲೈತವ ಸಿನೆ ಕೋಯಿಗೆ
ರೇಲಿ ಕೇಂದ್ರದಿಂದ ಅನಾ ಏಕ ಹಲಮನ್ ನಾದುನಿ ಏಕ ತುನಿ ಯಾಮನ ಲೈರಿ ಹುಜಿ ಅದಗೆ ಹುಜಿ ಪಾಕ್ ತಕ್ ನನ್ನ ನಾರಕದ್ರ ಹಾಬೆ ಕೋಯಿ ಸಿಗ್ನಬ ಹುಜಿ ಜಿ ಲೈ ಇಸಿಂಗ್ ಜಿ ಫತ್ತವನ ಥಕ್ನನ ಬಿಸಿಂಗ್ ಕೋಯಿ ಜಿ ಯಾಮ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಓಯ್
ಪೀಸ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಪೋರೋಂ ಪಾಟ್ಕ ತಾನರಗ ಅಥುಬ ಮತಂದ ಮಫಂ ಸಿಂಗ ಅಸಿದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಅಮಸು ತೌನವ ಥೌರಾಂಗ್ ತೌಜರಿ ಅದುಗ ಮರುವೈನ ಅಸಿ ಹೈಬೋಂ ಮಕೊಂಗ್ದ ಯುಂ ತೇಖ್ರಿಬ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಸಿದ ಐನ ಅಂಗಂಬ ಮತೆಂಗ್ ಪೀಗನಿ
A statue of Manipuri pony, also known as Samadun Ayangba, being built at Hingang Marjingcheng is set to complete by 2018. The statue will be one of the tallest structures in the entire northeast region. The structure atop Ibudo Marjingcheng will clearly show that the game of polo, Sagul Kangjai, originated from Manipur. Speaking to media persons today, General Secretary of Hingang United Clubs Organization and apex body of 12 clubs of Hingang, Sanaujom Tondang said the foundation of the 150 feet tall structure is complete and will be open to public by 2018. Although construction began in 2016 and estimated to be complete by December 2017, various issues prevailing in the state and incessant rain delayed the completion. Tondang appealed to the people to not cause hindrances to the construction of the structure, which will be a pride of Manipur.
Prithibida saktak na bagi pandam je thambagal oina na mapham asida koi project oina polo tourism project haibama ai poni project haibama adumai taudna tourism ga mari leina na semkol labagi part amani manipur miyamna su aduba mipum khudimona sigumba semgot sagat prajida apanba pividana aduga yamna thuna miyamda koi khusin naraga manipur miyamgi prithibida saktak na bado koi gi saitte gi su madu koi pamjai.
A meeting of State Level Road Safety Council SLRSC was held with Chief Minister Nongthoma Biren in chair yesterday. In a press release, Transport Commissioner M. Lakshmi Kumar said various issues concerning road safety measures being taken in the state and observations made by the Committee of Supreme Court on Road Safety were discussed at the meeting. And it's time for a small commercial break, but we'll be right back. Keep watching Impact News. Welcome back. You're watching Primetime English News. Let's see what else made news this Sunday. A 10-member delegation of Shiv Sena Manipur State, led by its president M. Tombi, will be leaving for Mumbai tomorrow to attend a national convention of the Sena on the 27th of this month. Relief Center for the Welfare of Differently Abled Persons, Northern Disabilities Institute and Disabled Development Association Manipur organized a legal awareness program on the rights of persons with disabilities under the aegis of Manipur State Legal Services Authority at Singzamai Hau Ground. Speakers at the program stressed that it is necessary to create awareness among the parents of deaf and mute, blind, mentally retarded children and to hold the awareness programs at schools. Advocate T.H. Premlata spoke on the violence against women with disabilities. Shingcha village in Kamjung district has been officially declared as a tourist spot for the presence of the beautiful flower locally called Wiyawan. Shingcha village is about 88 kilometers from Imphal. Wiyawan is a new ground pink orchid which grows and covers a stretch of low hillocks of Mount Wiyakachui of Shingcha village and blooms during July. It flourishes in isolation and her beauty was discovered and exposed to the outside world only after it was uploaded on the social media by native girls Mayopi and Filawan in 2015. Later, the beauty of the flower spread like wildfire across the state. The flower blossoms even more beautifully during rains. Animals do not eat them. Nepramanjor Pukrimapal Youth Development Association Nemyoda today felicitated 19 students who secured good marks in class 10 and 12 examinations conducted by BOSEM, KOHOSEM and CBSE at an event held at Nepramanjor Pukrimapal Community Hall today. The event was sponsored by Sobam Ombi Chongtham Ningol Inaubi. All Hyderabad Students Welfare Association ASWA distributed the third Meritorious Award 2017 and inaugurated a library at Hyderabad Part 1 Umang Laikon Community Hall on the fourth foundation day of the association today. Education Minister T.H. Radhesham and D.C. Thawal L. Nabakishore were present on the occasion. Sahitya Academy in collaboration with Naharol Sahitya Premi Samiti organized a seminar on Rajkumar Sanhal Singh BCom at Dev Literature Center on DM College campus today. Convener of Manipur Language Advisory Board H. Bihari, Officer in Charge of Sahitya Academy Kolkata Gautam Paul, President of Naharol Sahitya Premi Samiti L. Upendra Sharma and many literature enthusiasts attended the seminar. Both renowned and young writers presented papers on the life of Rajkumar Sanhal and his works. During his lifetime, Rajkumar Sanhal had written several books including Manipur Itihas, Bir Tikendrajit Singh, Thangal General, Glimpses of Manipur, Peep into Manipur and A Short History of Manipur. Ipudho Marjing Kubam Kanbalup Imkhukal organized a seminar on Ipudho Marjing Sapong Lakpa Amadi Ipudho Gas Sagunariba Singh under the aegis of Department of Art and Culture at Ipudho Marjing Community Hall, Haingang Ching today. General Secretary of Imkhukal, Vaikom Jiten said the seminar was organized to create awareness about Ipudho Marjing who invented the game of polo. He also maintained that the seminar will help in finding out the shrines of Ipudho Marjing since there are no written records available.
खुबमसी पृथ्वी लेबी मईद नतना सगोल कांगजी होबी सगोल कांगजी जगह मार्जिन इफ मार्जिन खुबना सगोल फारा सानबा सगोल कांगजी मा मरी लेने गिनीज बुक ऑफ वर्ल्ड रिकॉर्ड मैं लेरबनीना पुवारी मैम से सेंगुचर वेबसाइट क्या थाद इबदौ की मगुन से हेन हेन हेगलब मैं खंगद्रीब मैम इबदौ की मति मगुन से खाबीदीब सेमिनार पोग्राम से
पोस्टर ऑफ द मणिपुरी डिजिटल फिल्म थोइचा 3 वॉज रिलीज टुडे इम्पैक्ट टीवी इज द मीडिया पार्टनर ऑफ द हॉरर फिल्म डायरेक्टेड बाय जितेंद्र निगुंबा who has also written the story and screenplay. The two previous films, Thoicha 1 and 2, were appreciated by the cinegoers of Manipur. The film, which is produced by Kwejam Ibumcha, has popular actress Leshangthem Tonthuingambi in the lead role.
Akoina film si namnaba oinaba honarpada akoina nungdangi da namgada ba saruk yauba adagi mapham jagada yamna amamba adagi मैम यद खितंग अकीब फाउदब अदम नंब सिंप अदुब ठेन नंब खोप अदाद्दाब अवाब थेगी मणिपुर फिल्म मैम पुथे तोान तोब वरी क्या यूम थोचा तोब वरी पार्ट वन टू पुथोखरे अब पार्ट थ्री तोब मैम तोप तोप मौम पीग्राइन खेल
Thoubal district thrashed Kakching district 13-0 in a match of the state level Subrata Mukherjee under 17 girls football tournament played at Kumalam Park main stadium. TH Baby Sana scored 10 of the 13 goals while Hijam Anjali, El Roshibina and H Baleshwari netted one goal each. Bishnupur district trounced Ukhrul district 10-0 in another match played this morning. In a match played in the afternoon, Bishnupur district thrashed Chandil district 5-0. Jupiter Ashem, who bagged 5 golds and 1 silver and created a new record in the 5th Northeast Zone Shooting Championship held in Shillong, Meghalaya from July 5th to 28th, was felicitated today. The felicitation was held by Imphal Public School IPS. Jupiter is a class 9 student of the school. And before we wrap up the headlines, once again. In a shocking incident, a 15-year-old girl was shot dead in Morey. Family suspect one-sided love angle behind the murder. Speaker Yumnam Khemchan appeals to people to usher better change and not to accept cash from candidates during elections. Presence of MPCC President T.N. Haukip's picture in BJP hoardings creates a stir in Congress party. And people remember Rabina and Sanjit, who were killed in a fake encounter on their 8th death anniversary.